Trovato FaceTime. Quindi si è installato. Ok. Adesso vedi che sei tu qui. Di questo time mi restating. Ok, so actually, as I said again, this lab is actually a continuation will be covered in our coming lectures, okay, sessions. Okay, so I've already talked about material selection. We've already done some of about the lab three. Okay, the how we choose material, what is the procedure to choose material. Okay, so for this part, this regarding process selection. Okay, so with the concept of shape factor and process selection strategy, this laboratory is designed to give particular samples in order to understand shape factor and process selection. Okay, so the keyword here is process selection. Okay. Okay, so have with me. Okay, this the scenario is this is the scenario. Okay, the casting for aluminum connecting rod. This connecting rod is the link of oscillatory motion with rotary motion. Mean that for example, connecting the engine with the drive shaft, for example. Okay, used in internal combustion as engine as an example in Figure One. Figure one. These rods are 3D solid shape. Okay, as you can see here, you can Google even what are the shape of the connecting rod. That requires it is to be made from non-ferrous aluminum alloy. Okay, for purposes of being lightweight. Okay, we know that aluminum alloy have lower density compared to steel. The dimension of the connection rod. Such mass is about 300 gram, 300 grams, and minimum section is 8 mm. Mean the minimum thickness of this part is 8 mm. That's the minimum, so it can go. It is not less than 8 mm in thickness. The position of the connecting rod are not critical based on this figure two here. And since the balls and its faces are to be machined later, so machined here, the balls, maybe the holes are to be machined later. To the required precision, the minimum batch size of production is 100,000 units. So it's mentioned here. This is the explanation of the design. Okay, first you need to create the translation table. Fill up the information on the translation table 4.1 result 1, leave three variables to choice of process according to material that is chosen. Okay, so this is the same as you did with translation table for material based on material selection. Okay, in this case, the difference is that you use for process selection. So this is the translation table. Okay, for connecting rod. So function you put here as rod, or you want to put aluminum connecting rod, it doesn't matter. Okay. Okay. The objective you can put here as minimize. It doesn't mention explicitly, but you can put here minimize cost. So what are the constraints that we know of? Okay, what are the constraints that we know of from the text here? Okay, it already mentioned that the material, what material you're going to use, what are the shape, the mass, the minimum section thickness, the precision here. Not critical. It has to have a machine later, the boards area here, the holes, and minimum batch size of production is about 100,000 units, meaning that in one batch, you can manufacture about 100,000 units. So we can put here material, aluminium, shape, 3D. Mass 100 gram, and then minimum section. This the tolerance. Drawing here. Okay. As you can see here, the tolerance for the outside surfaces, I mean the outside surfaces is about plus minus 0.25. Okay. And for the balls, about 0.02. Okay. Mean that. So you can put here. If you look here closely, since it associates this plus minus 0.25, meaning that the maximum it can go is between 28.25 or 27.75. So that's a difference about 0.5 mm. Okay. Or about 500 micron. For the surfaces, and then the roughness we can say critical batch size 1,000 units. So the field variable would be the choice of process. Okay. So when we did for material selection, okay, you had to generate the material index or material indices, okay. But for process, we don't have to go through the process of creating the or deriving the material index, okay. We can straight away use the information given because it doesn't necessarily necessitate the use of the material index. So here we choose, we start with the entry level 2, okay, for our database. When we choose here select, okay, we choose from entry level 2 shaping. Why shaping? Because joining, it refers to joining of two components. Our part is not being joined, it's being, we have to make it into a shape of the rod. Surface treatment is the as a name, surface treatment of a product that's been you've already completed the final shape, the final dimension, okay, or just or if not the final shape, treatment of the surfaces for final use properly. So the we want to use because this is in the process we want to use for the process selection, so we use in the process universe database for shaping. So we put here shaping. So you see here for level 2, we have about 60 process in the database, 60 process. If you change, for example, for level 3, okay, about 230 process, a very advanced process, much more detailed. So we start up with just level 2 first, okay. For shipping, we have about 60 process. Okay, for level 3 will be much more. Okay, just now I just choose for all process. So we start with choosing graph. Okay, for the y-axis. Okay, so from the instruction, it says here y-axis we choose for mass range. So we choose physical attributes. Mass range, okay, for the y-axis. And for the x-axis, we click on advanced trees. Okay, we choose material universe, meaning that we choose based on the what kind of process that the material for aluminium can undergo. Okay, choose non-ferrous aluminium. Click on insert. Okay, and then okay again, and we got this. So from all 60 process for shipping, of all the 60, 27 processes that the aluminium alloy can be used. Okay, which meaning that aluminium alloy can use 27 out of the 60 shaping process. Okay, yeah, when you understand shape, meaning that we create, we get regardless of the raw material of the aluminium, so we shape into the shape that we want. And we use mass range here. We see here the mass range, okay, up until more than 10,000 kilogram to the lowest. Yeah, this is about 1 gram, I believe. Yes, 1 gram, 2.01 gram. Okay, so then, so how do we use the information that we have? So we just click on limit, and then we choose, we input all of the information for the constraints that we have. So it's solid 3D. Okay, the mass range we put here about a range. About minimum, sorry, this, since the unit is in kilogram, so we put here 0.3 gram. Okay, it says here the minimum thickness, ratio thickness would be 8 mm. Tolerance we put here about minimum is 0.5. okay, roughing it doesn't mention. Okay, it's not critical. Okay, for the process characteristic, okay, you can choose primary shaping process. What does primary shaping process means? If you click on the definition here, so primary shaping process takes an unshaped material, ingot, powder, pellet, granules, or resin, and give it shape. Meaning that this is the first primary shaping process, regardless of what our raw material is in the shape, is in the, it comes in what form. Okay, so since this is the first shaping process that our material needs to go through, taking the shape of the connecting rod, so we choose as the primary shaping process. Economic attributes, okay, again we key in as the economic batch size for 100,000. Yes, so that apply. So here we got from 27, we down to 7 process. Okay, 7 process that we comes down with our selection. Okay, from 27. Oh, before I forgot, click on the on the first here. We choose height field record. So these are the process that we are left with 7. Out of the 20, we begin with 60 process that all kind of materials that can be used, and then when we choose for aluminium, we are left with 27 that aluminium can be shaped, they can be, it can use. Of course, it will leave out, for example, hand lay up, because aluminium can be hand lay up, for example, or resin transformer, and those are for polymers or for composites. So out of that 60, then we left with 27, and we key in all the constraints, then we are left with 7. So what you need to do next, then we just screenshot. Okay, you can screenshot this part. Okay, or better yet, you can, I think better you can just screenshot this part and just go to here, and you can okay. okay, after filling the constraints. And then the final process candidates, result 6. So, okay, result 2. And list the, I asked for the process selection chart. So, you have to screenshot. This is the process selection chart. And paste in result 2. Okay. So the final process candidate, then only you screenshot this part and paste in result 3. That's it. Okay, moving on to the next step. Okay, then what would be the we already know so these are the process that the aluminium alloy can go through. Okay, so for what if, okay, based on process that aluminium alloy can undergo to achieve the reconstruction of the list of organic process, two of them seem a bit different than the rest, list below two of the process that are in a different family of process that than the rest in result. Within this, okay, out of the 7, 2 are a different family, so you have to choose and write your result in result 4. Okay. Between the two, then you can look at the CS software, just choose, and won't give the answer, so you can do it yourself. And it says if the type pressure is, if you read again the information provided in 1.1, it mentioned that the pause will be machined later. This means that secondary process is required for this product. If the company decides to push using casting process, the primary shaping process, how would the list of candidates of processes be? Okay, so we follow the same here. It's just that we change in the y-axis with this, okay? We highlight casting. So if I choose here, edit stage, x-axis, and x-axis, advanced, and then I'll remove this, trees, shaping, I choose casting, and I'll be left with the same limit, okay, the same information here, limit. So we are left with this, okay, this, okay. And if we, since it already mentioned that it will be machined later, okay, so then we can I'll show next on how you can choose for the machining. Okay, but this is for the casting, so you left with just 5 process for casting. So for that you can follow the screenshot for result 5. So just screenshot this area and paste in result 5. And final processes, just choose this, and you can paste in this out. And that's it. There will be just simple as that. Okay. Result 4, this you can search for yourself. Okay. What will be the two process? So I'll show this is not covered in the lab sheet. Okay. How we determine the process, because if you look at the design, this area needs to be machined, okay, and the tolerance about plus minus 0.02, that is the tolerance. Okay so if I again edit this, okay, and I choose the x-axis, we go back to trees and material universe, metal alloy, we choose aluminium. Okay. So we come back with a 7. Okay. And if we choose it on this side, okay, so if we put the tolerance, okay, the maximum tolerance about 0.02. Now we go with the machining process only. Okay. Sorry, not 0.02, it will be 0.04 because the difference of so about 40 micron. Okay. So if we apply here, these are the process for getting the dimension, the final dimension for the balls for machining. Okay, that can for aluminium, that can go through either grinding, milling, turning or boring. So the most then if it, I mean we can choose between these three processes finally before the boring process. Okay, to drill the hole. Okay, so basically that is the lab. Okay, does anyone have any question? Ada soalan tak? You don't have any question? Hmm? Ada soalan ke tak ada? Okay,
yes, sir.
Ah, okay dah. Okay, so everyone just complete individually the lab sheet. Okay, I've shown how you can complete it, and then just upload the lab sheet in ULearn. Okay, don't forget to tick for your attendance for today. Okay, and we'll continue with our lecture session, replacement and also next lecture session next week, inshallah. Okay, so thank you everyone. Terribly sorry, I apologize for the error with my side for the my PC crash just now. Okay, if any question, just you can use our Teams and I will upload this video with the crash even. If I can edit, if I have a time editing, then I'll be uploaded in YouTube. Okay, so thank you everyone for your attention today. Okay, so everyone have a
so submit sebelum jam 11 eh?
Jam 11, betul.
Alright. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, you're complete. Okay. Okay, bye, bye. Okay, have a great day. Okay, thank you. Sorry for interrupting your weekend. Eh? Thank you very much. Bye.
Thank you.